dear young graduates standing at the crossroads and then pondering about your future. Let me share some of my reminiscences with you and based on that, give you some suggestions for your consideration. My little granddaughter, who is going to the third grade, came home one day with a project to interview the grandpa. After the initial data was recorded, like my name, date of birth, place of birth, etc., she asked the first question, how was your schooling different from the schooling of the present day kids? I told her that I was born in a very poor family in a remote village. There was no electricity at that time in my house and consequently no electrically operated gadgets. I walked to my school barefooted 2 miles either way and I carried my plebeian lunch in a small tiffin box. Then she asked, how were you different from your classmates? I told her that I was a brilliant boy, standing always first in the class. And I was a very good painter and painted so many pictures. I was not a great sportsperson, but I played a little basketball in school. Then finally she asked, what did you want to become after your schooling? I was not sure. Being a very poor boy, I thought that I will not be able to continue my education beyond the school. But God favored me. I stood first in all the examinations, got scholarships, which helped me to climb up the academic ladder. I did my bachelor's degree in civil engineering, then master's degree in structural engineering, and finally ended up with a doctorate from Moscow as a UNESCO fellow. I joined the IIT Bombay right at its inception in 1958 and had a very long academic career extending over nearly 55 years, during which I had a very rewarding teaching profession, guiding research, holding very prestigious administrative positions too. Now, I give this one example mainly to show that for a person who has got a broad vision and a focused mission, nothing can stop him. No obstacle can come in his way of mounting the ladder of success. I will give a few examples. No obstacle, either in the form of physical handicap, social stigma, or extreme poverty, can stop him from the path of progress. One example is, there was a boy named Tommy in America. When he went to school, the teacher sent him back saying that he cannot continue the education in school because he was short of hearing. His mother took it as a challenge, gave him homeschooling, and he rose to the highest level of academic achievement, then switched over to path-breaking research and inventions. Now, it was Thomas Alva Edison who invented the electric bulb, which has illuminated the whole world. One day, after he had mounted the pinnacle of fame, his laboratory got burned down and he was sitting outside that laboratory laughing. People asked him why he was laughing. He said that all my follies have been burned down in that laboratory. Now I can start all over again learning from all those follies. That was an example of a person who, in spite of his physical handicaps, rose to the highest level of name and fame. Then there was another boy in Calcutta who was asked by his teacher what he wanted to become. He said he wanted to become a coach driver. His classmates laughed. When the boy went home and told his mother what happened, she said there's nothing wrong in becoming coach driver. She showed him a picture and told him, you should become a coach driver like the person in that picture. It was the picture of Lord Krishna driving Arjuna's chariot in the Kurukshetra battlefield. He took it seriously, and it was a Swami Vivekananda who drove the chariot of the great Hindu philosophy and spread it all over the its glory all over the world. Then there was a poor boy, Abraham Lincoln, who had no formal schooling in his childhood. He borrowed books whenever he could and then read them with avid interest, you see, in the light lit by him with firewood collected from the forest. Now, he also wrote on barks of trees with charcoal pieces. Now, it was the same poor boy, Abraham Lincoln, who rose to the level of the 16th US president. And during his second term, when he died at 7:45 a.m. on April 15th, 1865, he had liberated, he has got salvation for all this, for all the people in the in America. He liberated them from the bonds of slavery. Now, all these examples show that no obstacle, however serious it may be, will stand in the path of a dedicated, motivated person from achieving what he wanted. That's why they say the heights where great men reached and kept were not attained by sudden flight, but they, while their companions slept, were toiling upwards in the night. But we must remember here that simply academic or professional achievements will not bring societal recognition or glory in the life of a person. What society will identify and respect our virtues. Thiruvalluvar, the greatest Tamil poet and philosopher, wrote, "Eenda poluthil periduvakkum tanmaganai shandon enak kettathoy." The mother will be proud of the son only for his virtues. By virtues we mean honesty, compassion, care, love, affection for the parents, friendship, and above all, societal service. But there are certain bad qualities or habits which are also to be avoided. Ostentatious living and spending has to be avoided at all costs. Then there is another evil which has to be eschewed or discarded at all costs. When Swami Vivekananda, he was called Narendra Dutt in his college days, heard about the fact that his guru Ramakrishna was a little sick, he rushed to see him, and while rushing, he forgot to wear his footwear. In Bengal, the tradition is you go barefooted to the house of a person where somebody is dead. His friend Bipin Chandra Ghosh asked, "Why are you going barefooted? Who is dead?" Back came the reply. He said, "My personal ego is dead, and I am going to meet that person who killed my personal ego." That shows very clearly, personal ego is something which has to be discarded at all costs. Now, coming to the future path which new graduates may be interested in choosing, there are two distinct paths. One is the academic profession, which may not bring much of money, but still has got its own glory, in the sense that it involves teaching, research, and research guidance, thereby helping many of the dedicated, interested young minds to grow and achieve success in their life. The other is the entrepreneurship, which, if pursued with dedication and interest, will give you a lot of professional experience, bringing money also in route, and that will also help in expanding the industry or the economy of the country and provide employment and growth for many people. Now the question arises, what should we choose? I should say that it should be a judicious combination of both. the appropriate time. Now, I attended two lectures in of the MBA program in Harvard Medical Harvard Business School. One was on finance by a professor, a young professor, who had taken to the academic profession immediately after doing his doctorate. Another was a very senior professional who, after having spent several years as the CEO of a very leading company, returned to the teaching profession, which was his childhood passion. Now, both of them have made marks in their own respective fields, but I feel that it is necessary for a growing mind to do a judicious combination. Academics will someday help to share the knowledge with lots of dedicated, interested young ones, you see, to make them grow and make a mark in their own respective profession. Bala Gangadhar Tilak, see, the great freedom fighter, left his teaching profession and went over to the freedom movement, and it was thought that, well, India will gain independence, you see, during his lifetime itself. So his friends asked him what he will become, whether he will become the Prime Minister or the President of Independent India. He said, none of them. I will return to the teaching profession. That way I can train and shape several Prime Ministers and Presidents rather than becoming one myself. That was a great lesson which we should understand in the proper perspective and ponder over it, and then utilize these guidelines in our future courses. God is always there to guide you along the right path. Academic and entrepreneurship are like the two rails of a railway track, which will guide you or guide your career to speed up along the chosen line. Now, let me end up by wishing you all the best in whatever line you have chosen, with a verse from Aditya Hridayam in praise of the sun god. Bano Bhaskara Marthanda Chandrasvi Divagara Ayurarogya Maishwaryam Sriyam Putram Chadehimi. O sun god whose friends spreads life and light in the whole world, let give us health, wealth, happiness and prosperity, and a posterity which we will be really proud of. Thank you.